question 33, again, we're asked for the solution to this equation on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, so one time around the circle. This time we have a double angle formula, so we'll probably to be able to solve this. We're going to want to look at our cosine of 2x, and we have multiple equations. I'm going to guess that the most likely one out of the last one is to get a quadratic. Since we have a sine x, we're either going to have cosine squared minus sine squared. That's probably not going to be helpful. If we have a cosine squared, we'd have to change that. So I'm going to go with this one here. We've got three choices, and I think getting everything in terms of one of the functions is going to be our best strategy. So we're going to use this last one, cosine of 2 alpha, 2x, 1 minus 2 sine of x. Okay, so I'm going to write that down here, that the cosine, let's go like that, cosine of 2x is equal to 1 minus the sine squared of x, wait, or 2 times, see, I always have to check, 2 times the sine squared, okay. 2 times sine squared. Let's make it a little cleaner. Minus 2 sine squared x. So what we're going to do is this is going to go in place of the sine of 2x. Okay. So let's write our equation that we start with is 2 sine x plus cosine of 2x equals 1. I'm going to make this substitution here. This goes in there. So we end up with 2 sine x plus 1 minus 2 sine squared x. And when I'm plugging in, I kind of like to have parentheses just in case. You'll see we don't really need it, but in case, like if this was a negative, you've got to make sure you do this distribution and stuff. So nothing distributes. We're okay without those. And what do we end up with? Let's kind of put this in order. I like having my sine, the square, to be positive. So again, I think, okay, we really don't need these. I don't want to have to rewrite this multiple times. I can add this to this side. So I'm going to move everything to the left side. So I'm going to add 2 sine squared x to both sides. So I'm going to have 2 sine squared x. I would subtract 1 from both sides. Ooh, when I subtract 1, I get 0. So I get 0 on this side, 0 on that side. And then I'm going to subtract 2 sine x from both sides. Minus 2 sine x. That's kind of nice because this actually factors pretty nicely. 0, I can take a 2 and a sine out. 2 sine. 2 sine x. What's left in here? There's since this was squared, there's a sine x left in there. And when this came out, you divide that out, there's a 1 left, minus 1. So we have, and again, I can think of it, it's a single thing, but it's these two are multiplied together, they're equal to 0. So when is 2 sine x equal to 0? Divide both sides by 2. Still get that sine x equals 0. There's only one place that happens, and that's when x is 0. How do I know that? If you look at the unit circle, there's only one place that the y-coordinate is 0. Oh, wait. I'm glad I looked. There's two places. There's at 0 and at pi, right? It's over here. So sometimes we get too confident. Think, I'm a trig master. But I almost missed one side, pi. pi would also give us sine x being 0. So there's two places. Oops, almost missed it. So this one, the other solution comes when sine x minus 1 equals 0. Add 1 to both sides. You get that sine x equals positive 1. Now, that I'm a little bit more confident with, I hope. There's one place where the y is equal to 1, and that's at the north pole. It's at the top, it's pi over 2. Because down at the bottom, at the south pole, the y value is negative 1. So there's only one place there. So this one has a solution of x equals pi over 2. So we do end up with three solutions, and again, it's between there. You could think, oh, at 0, go around 2 pi, but remember, 2 pi is not included in this interval. It goes all the way up to 2 pi, but not including 2 pi because of this parentheses. So our answers are going to be 0, pi, and pi over 2. Or, you know, if you want to put them in order, I don't think it matters. They don't say you have to have it in order. But, okay. So that is 33.